In today's Medicoapps Masterclass, we will learn about Sodium Potassium Pump. Let's start by looking at the structure of sodium potassium pump, also called as sodium potassium ATPase. Essentially, it is a heterodimer with two alpha and two beta subunits. The alpha subunit is larger, of about 100 kilodalton, while the beta subunit is smaller with about 55 kilodalton. The alpha subunit, as you can see in the diagram, has two parts, the intracellular and the extracellular portions. The intracellular portion has sodium binding receptors and ATPase activity site. An easy way to remember is, since the sodium has to be pumped from inside the cell, hence the intracellular portion will have the sodium binding receptors. The extracellular portion of alpha subunit has potassium binding receptors along with Ouabain binding site. On a side note, Ouabain is a cardiac glycoside, also known as G-streptofantin, is a plant-derived toxic substance, and that was traditionally used as an arrow poison in Eastern Africa, both for hunting and warfare. Finally, the beta subunit has three extracellular glycosylation sites. Let's look at the mechanism by which sodium potassium or sodium potassium ATPase works. The first step in the function starts with binding of three sodium ions to the intracellular portion of alpha subunit of the pump. Once the sodium binds, then the phosphorylation reaction takes place. The phosphorylation leads to the opening of the channel and release of the sodium ions into the extracellular space. The phosphorylated sodium potassium pump has a high affinity for potassium ions, and hence now two ions of potassium attaches to the sodium potassium pump. The attachment of potassium leads to the dephosphorylation of the channel. The dephosphorylated state has poor affinity for potassium ion, which is now released inside the cell. The dephosphorylated state has high affinity for sodium, which then again attaches itself to the inner side of the alpha subunit to continue the cycle. This completes the sodium potassium ATPase cycle. Let's move forward and look at the function of sodium potassium ATPase. On the most basic level, it acts as an electrogenic pump, since three positive ions are moved out and two positive ions are moved in. In net, one positive charge is moved out of the cell, making the electrochemical membrane potential inside the cell as negative as compared to the outside cell. Not to mention, the sodium potassium pump is very critical to maintain the cell volume, and loss of sodium potassium ATPase function will lead to the swelling of cells. Also, it is seen that the sodium potassium pump is critical in control of neuronal activity states, especially in cerebellar Purkinje fibers and accessory olfactory bulb, wherein they control and set the intrinsic activity. Finally, the sodium potassium pump is critical for functioning of many secondary active transport which uses sodium, like sodium glucose symporter in renal tubules. Let's look at the factors which stimulate and inhibit the sodium potassium pump. The factor which stimulates sodium potassium pump is increased intracellular sodium and hormones such as thyroid, aldosterone and insulin. The factors which inhibit sodium potassium pump are congestive heart failure and chronic kidney failure, as well as digitalis toxicity and dopamine. Before we finish, let me give you two fun facts about sodium potassium pump. Sodium potassium pump contributes only 4 millivolt as to the total resting membrane potential of 90 millivolt, which is just about 5% of the total resting membrane potential. And one of the major energy using processes in the body is the sodium potassium pump. In a normal cell, around 24% of the energy is used to run this pump. In neurons, as high as 70% of energy is used to run sodium potassium pump. Today's brain teaser question is, the sodium potassium pump is inhibited during the congestive heart failure. This statement is true or false? If you know the answer, write in the comment below. I would really love if you can also comment your feedback on how I can improve this Medicoapps Masterclass so that it can be of more use to you. If you like the masterclass on sodium potassium pump, don't forget to subscribe to Medicoapps Masterclass by clicking here. Also, hit the bell icon to receive a notification whenever any new Medicoapps Masterclass is uploaded. Also, check out this next Medicoapps Masterclass especially for you. Hope you find it useful.